Fight Club is a 1999 American film directed by David Fincher and stars Brad Pitt, Edward Norton, and Helena Bonham Carter. It is based on the 1996 novel of the same name by Chuck Palahniuk. Norton plays an unnamed narrator who is discontented with his whole white-collar job. He forms a fight club with the soap salesman Tyler Durden, played by Pitt, and becomes embroiled in a relationship with a mysterious woman, Marla Singer, played here by Bonham Carter. Palahniuk's novel was optioned by Fox 2000 Pictures producer Laura Siskin, who hired Jim Ulls to write a film adaptation. Fincher was selected because of his enthusiasm for the story. He developed the script with Ulls and sought screenwriting advice from the cast and others in the film industry. It was filmed in around Los Angeles from July to December 1998. He and the cast compared the film to Rebel Without a Cause in 1955 and The Graduate in 1967, with the theme of conflict between Generation X and the value system of advertising. Studio executives did not like the film, and they restructured Fincher's intended marketing campaign to try and reduce anticipated losses. Fight Club failed to meet the studio's expectations at the box office and received polarized reactions from critics. It was ranked as one of the most controversial and talked about films of the 1990s. The film later found commercial success with its home video release, establishing Fight Club as a cult classic and causing media to revisit the film. In 2009, on the 10th anniversary of the film's release, the New York Times dubbed it the defining cult movie of our time. The cast includes Edward Norton as the narrator, a chronic insomniac who is unfulfilled by his job as an automobile recall specialist and material wealth it affords him. As a substitute for therapy, he attends support groups for problems he doesn't really have, such as alcoholism and cancer. Brad Pitt is Tyler Durden, a soap salesman who befriends the narrator, and later the two of them start the Fight Club. Helena Bonham Carter as Marla Singer, another imposter at the support groups. Meatloaf as Robert Paulson, a man the narrator has befriended at a cancer support group. And Jared Leto as Angel Face, a young Fight Club recruit and member of Project Mayhem. Initially, producer Ross Bell met with actor Russell Crowe to discuss his candidacy for the role of Tyler Durden. Then other producer, Art Linson, who joined the project late, met with Pitt regarding the same role. Linson was the senior producer of the two, so the studio sought to cast Pitt instead of Crowe. Pitt was looking for a new film after the domestic failure of 1998's film Meet Joe Black, and the studio believed Fight Club would be more commercially successful with a major star. The studio signed Pitt for $17.5 million. For the role of the unnamed narrator, the studio desired a sexier marquee name, such as Matt Damon, to increase the film's commercial prospects. It's also considered Sean Penn. Fincher instead considered Norton based on his performance in the 1996 film The People vs. Larry Flint. Other studios approaching Norton for leading roles in developing films like The Talented Mr. Ripley and The Man on the Moon. He was later cast in Runaway Jury, but the film did not reach production. 20th Century Fox offered Norton $2.5 million for Fight Club. He could not accept the offer immediately because he still owed Paramount Pictures a film. He signed a contractual obligation with Paramount to appear in one of the studio's future films for a smaller salary. Norton later satisfied this obligation with his role in the 2003 film The Italian Job. Eventually, in January 1998, it was announced that Pitt and Norton had been cast. The actors prepared by taking lessons in boxing, taekwondo, grappling, and soap making. Pitt even visited a dentist to have pieces of his front teeth chipped off so his character would not have the perfect teeth. The pieces were restored after filming concluded. Fincher's first choice for the role of Marla Singer was Gianne Garofalo. While Fincher initially stated that she turned it down because she objected to the film's sexual content, in an interview in 2020, Garofalo revealed that she did accept the role but was dropped because Norton believed she was poorly suited to it. The filmmakers considered Courtney Love and Winona Ryder as early candidates. Love claimed she was cast as Marla Singer but was fired after she rejected Pitt's pitch for a film about her late husband, Kurt Cobain. The studio wanted to cast Reese Witherspoon, but Fincher felt she was too young. Finally, Fincher chose to cast Bonham Carter based on a performance in the 1997 film The Wings of a Dove. Some fun trivia notes. Additionally, the film's release was postponed due to the Columbine High School massacre, as the content was deemed too controversial at the time. Throughout the film, there are subliminal flashes of Starbucks coffee cups inserted by Fincher. This was done as a commentary on the pervasiveness of the branding and consumerism in modern society. The production team created a fake IKEA catalogue specifically for the film. The catalogue is briefly shown in a scene where the narrator explains his obsession with furniture and interior design. Tyler Durden's iconic red leather jacket became a popular fashion item after the film's release. The jacket was custom-made for Brad Pitt and has since become a symbol of rebelliousness and counterculture. The film's fight scenes were choreographed by Jeff Imada, a martial artist and fight coordinator. The actors underwent extensive training to perform the fights realistically. Many of the punches or hits were real, resulting in numerous on-set injuries. Tyler Durden has a set of rules in the film that he shares with the members of the Fight Club. Some of these rules include: the first rule of Fight Club is you do not talk about Fight Club. These rules have become widely recognized and referenced in popular culture. In the same breath, director David Fincher said he included this in the script as a message to the audience to not talk about the movie Fight Club, so as to not ruin the movie's famous twist at the end. Despite receiving mixed reviews upon its initial release, Fight Club has gained significant cult following over the years. While it didn't perform well at the box office, the film has since become highly regarded for its bold themes, striking visuals, and unconventional storytelling. Following the film's release, several Fight Clubs were reported to have started in the United States. Members would post videos online after their fights, leading to authorities breaking up the clubs. In 2006, an unwilling participant from a local high school was injured in a Fight Club in Arlington, Texas, and the DVD sales of the fight led to the arrest of six teenagers. An unsanctioned Fight Club was also started at Princeton University, where matches were held on campus. The film was also suspected of influencing Luke Helder, a college student who planted pipe bombs in mailboxes in 2002. Helder's goal was to create a smiley pattern on the map of the United States, similar to the scene in the Fight Club, in which a building is vandalized to have a smiley on the exterior. On July 16, 2009, a 17-year-old who had formed his own Fight Club in Manhattan was charged with detonating a homemade bomb outside a Starbucks coffee shop in Upper East Side of Manhattan. The New York City Police Department reported the suspect was trying to emulate Project Mayhem. Now, this film is an absolute classic. It's a thought-provoking film that delves into various themes and societal critiques. And ironically, it was a film, when I initially watched it, I just didn't get or understand. I think it's a film you have to be in the right sort of space and mind for. But upon second viewing, it absolutely blew me away. It's so nuanced, it's so layered, and of course the magnificent twist at the end is one of those that you can never ever see coming. But upon watching it a second time, you just see all the little Easter eggs that David Fincher laid before our eyes, alluding to, of course, the magnificent twist at the end. For me, it is one of the best twists in cinema history. The film is also a commentary on so many things. For example, masculinity and identity crisis. The film explores the crisis of masculinity in modern society. The protagonist, known here of course as the narrator, is a disillusioned office worker who suffers from a lack of purpose and identity. He feels emasculated by his consumer-driven lifestyle and seeks an outlet for his frustrations. The creation of the underground Fight Club, led by the enigmatic Tyler Durden, becomes a sort of manifestation of the narrator's repressed masculinity and the rebellion against societal norms. The film also strongly criticizes the consumerist culture that dominates contemporary society. The narrator finds himself trapped in a cycle of mindless consumerism, seeking solace in material possessions and conforming to societal expectations. Tyler Durden challenges this way of life by promoting anarchy and rejecting materialistic values. The iconic line, "the things you own end up owning you," serves as a powerful reminder of the film's critique of consumerism. I also found the film explores an allure of consequences of rebellion and anarchy. The underground Fight Club, initially conceived as a way to experience an adrenaline rush and gain a sense of control, evolves into a larger movement called Project Mayhem. The members of Project Mayhem engage in acts of vandalism and domestic terrorism, embodying a desire to dismantle society's structures. However, the film also portrays the destructive nature of unchecked rebellion, leading to chaos and, of course, loss of identity. The film also highlights the sense of alienation and disassociation experienced by individuals in modern society. The narrator feels detached from his own life and creates an alter ego in Tyler Durden. The relationship between the two characters blurs the lines of reality and fiction, reflecting the narrator's struggle to find meaning in his own existence. The film suggests that the search for an identity can lead to extreme measures of complete and utter self-destruction. This is also a film about power and control, both of the individual and societal level. The underground Fight Club and Project Mayhem provide a platform for men to assert dominance and reclaim power in their own lives. However, as the film progresses, it becomes clear that Tyler Durden's relationship is dictatorial and oppressive. The themes of power and control reveal the dangers of consequences of unchecked authority. The film, of course, also deals with huge issues like mental health and self-destruction, through the narrator's struggle with insomnia and dissociated identity disorder. The violent and chaotic nature of the Fight Club scenes serve as an outlet for the narrator's repressed emotions, highlighting the destructive potential and unresolved psychological issues. The film raises some fantastic questions about the nature of mental illness and the search for purpose and connection, and in many ways it was ahead of its time. Look, this is a complex film. It's layered, it's nuanced, and it's one of those films that you can keep watching over and over and learning new things every time you do. I could see why it was deemed too controversial at the time, as it's almost ahead of its time. In so many ways, it's faultless and doesn't date a day. And the way the film explores themes of masculinity, consumerism, identity, rebellion, and the destructive consequences of unchecked ideals, it challenges societal norms, raises existential questions, and provides a social commentary on the modern human condition. With its superb acting here, particularly from Norton, Bonham Carter, and one of the best performances by Brad Pitt, and the startling yet magnificent directing from David Fincher. This is a film that will encourage viewers to reflect on their own lives, values, and the impact of societal pressures. This film is truly a masterpiece, with a stunning script, and of course, one of the best twists in cinema history. Fight Club gets a 10 out of 10.